Okay guys, today we're going to learn how to press out the crankshaft out of our one half of our two-stroke engine cases. So what I want to focus on before I flip this over is that we need to be able to grab some real meat of this engine case on both these sides to support it so that we have room to press this down. So one thing, we have these taller plates here so that we can get ourselves clearance. We'll set it up and see what this looks like. Does anybody have an idea how far we have to press it before it's going to pop loose?
About a half inch,
about the width of a bearing. Because that's the only thing holding it in is that other crank bearing right now. The thing I want you to realize to be careful of is do not be carrying this around like this. I've seen cranks just fall out. It's cocked on the bench or, you know, gravity is holding it in, and then you flip it over and go to carry it and it's just going to fall out. It's not a good thing. So we want to use some caution on that. Does that make sense? So inside of this case, you guys remember that there's always dowel pins. So you always got to look to see if the dowel pins are in here, something that's going to catch or get us to hang up. When we start to put, and this is a smaller press, only a 2010 press. I love this. It's my favorite quick, easy to use, lightweight press. You can move it around, do a lot of things with it, especially stuff like this. So I'm going to go ahead and notice my fingers are supporting the crank right now.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to just kind of slide this stuff over a little bit here and just start to kind of get in place. A lot of people call these parallels or whatnot, our supports here. I really wish that they were a little bit longer. So for you guys, when you're using these, you got some caution that they don't fall down in. They're precision ground on a couple of sides, so I really need you to try and not drop them. Make sense?
Yep.
And the other thing I'm trying to do is make sure that this is somewhere in a relationship to where I can press it straight out. Does that make sense? Can we see in here that the crank is not touching the parallels? Can we see the gap there on both sides?
Yeah.
Okay, good stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, so do you notice too here, since I'm attempting to do this myself with no help, I don't want to let go of this case. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask for a volunteer here that can kind of support the case for me back here, because I've got to be able to hold the crankshaft. Can I get a volunteer?
Yeah.
Got Robert there? Okay, so the other thing I need to do is I need to come up with something that I can fit in between here to press this out. Now this hole isn't gonna really allow me to get full meat on here, so I don't like this one. It's a Harley wrist pin. It's a real common thing I use for a press because it's made of steel. One thing that I like to do is I do like to use aluminum. And so here's an aluminum plug. This is out of a snowmobile clutch, nothing that important. And the reason I like the aluminum is the aluminum's softer than steel and it will allow a crush. Does that make sense? See, I'm going to tighten up the jack and I'm going to go ahead. What I've asked you guys to do is you're just going to get close and you're literally just going to kiss it, just like that. Have me come look at it, verify we're in a good place. Support underneath here. Do you remember when we did the Harley cranks, we did something right here and on both sides? We put some wood in there, right? Because that Harley crank was really super heavy. On this guy here, I'm going to go ahead. It's literally just this easy. I just got to be really intentional and ready to take that out of there. Go ahead. Now you notice here, I can't come through because of the rod. I got to be able to come back on top. And there's just a lot of intention into how I'm holding that crankshaft. Another recommendation, take this out right away. You see how I clip my head on it? It's a good idea to get this on the floor or back up here, whatever's gonna be most comfortable for you so you don't whack yourself in the head there. You also see how the different parts that I grabbed to use as a pressing, you know, middle piece there. Do you notice how they're sitting in the cradle of this V? Don't do this stuff. Don't do this because you're just asking for trouble. It's just going to fall off there. So this is not a place to store sockets or anything else. Make sure that you have it in the channel. One thing I'd like to do is create a little tray on here where you could put pieces and maybe you pull a dowel pin out that you notice. It'd be nice to have a place to collect things, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, guys, that's how you press a crank out of a two-stroke, and this was in there tight. I mean, I would have to, if I beat that thing with a hammer, I could take a chance of knocking out a true. Probably still wouldn't, because the other side isn't supported, but the thing is why take the chance when you have the right tool?